So, first question I would have for you is, how did the two of you first meet?
We met on a double date at Kennywood, and went out to eat after that and started dating ever since.
It was actually set up on a blind date at Kennywood by the Mr. Josh Seeky.
Yeah, there's a lot of special memories. There's not one in particular, but there's tons.
Pirate games.
No detail whatsoever.
We fell in love, you know, we got everything, both of us got a lot of things in common. Man, that's pretty much about it, you know.
I honestly don't know. It's just one of them things when you know, you just get that feeling that you just know. When I first met him, he had his arms up rested against the thing at Kennywood on the skyrocket, and he had the biggest pitters ever. And I looked at my friend, I was like, oh my God, does he wear deodorant?
I just wanted to tell her I love her, and we'll have a good special night.
Please don't throw up, and know that I do love you, and it's almost over with.
I'm not a drink, but it concerns her. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
So you're gonna have that dip, you make that right. If you go up too far, it caves on the
floor.
Hey, he looked
up my teeth though. You gotta go. Hey,
he called me.
Thank you.
Let us unite our hearts together in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Lord God, we just humble ourselves before your holy presence with grateful and thankful hearts. We just call upon you today, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Just wanted to invite your presence here in our midst. We just welcome you, Holy Spirit, God. As we come together, as Mary and Jeff have come together, Lord, to bring their two lives together in holy matrimony, which is a pleasing unto you, Lord God. And as we call upon you, we just ask your blessings, Lord, upon this day, upon their marriage, upon their lives, and upon their home, as we hold them up before you. And as we just ask you, Lord, to bless us with your presence here as they exchange these vows this day, as we ask it in Jesus' name, amen. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man, this woman, in holy matrimony, which is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men and not to be entered into unadvisedly, but advisedly, and not lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. To this holy estate, these two persons present come now to be joined. If any man can show just cause why they might not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold their peace. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Jeff, Mary, I require and charge you both as you will answer at the dreadful day of judgment when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know of any impediment why you may not lawfully be joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be ye well assured that if any person are joined together, otherwise than as God's word doth allow, their marriage is not lawful.
Jeff, will you have Mary to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony?
I do.
Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Mary, wilt thou have Jeff to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony?
I will.
Wilt thou obey him and serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him as long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Jeff, will you repeat after me? I, Jeff.
I, Jeff.
Take thee, Mary.
Take thee, Mary.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and health.
To love.
To love.
To cherish.
To cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us apart.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I give thee my love.
I give you my love.
Mary, will you repeat after me?
Mm-hmm.
I, Mary.
I, Mary.
Take thee, Jeff.
Take thee, Jeff.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
Cherish.
Cherish.
And to obey.
And to obey.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I give thee my love.
I give thee my love.
Jeff, what is the visible token of your pledge?
The ring. The ring.
Jeff, will you take this ring and place it on the third finger of Mary's left hand and repeat after me? As a pledge.
As a pledge.
And in token.
In token.
Of the vows between us made.
And the vows between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen. Mary, what is the visible token of your love?
This ring.
Okay, Mary, will you take this ring, place it on the third finger of Jeff's left hand, and repeat after me. As a pledge.
As a pledge.
And in token.
And in token.
Of the vows between us made.
Of the vows between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now we're going to have a reading from the scriptures.
Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another.
Mary and Jeff are lighting the candle representing Mr. and Mrs. Frank Manown and also Mary's father, Mr. Ricky Yogurt.
You know, sometimes that's what marriage is like. You have to struggle together, but you got to endure. He says, let us not be weary in well-doing. If we continue, we're going to reap in due season if we faint not. So you don't want to become weary. I thought you was going to continue until you got that lit.
We're pressing for time.
Pardon?
I said, it's okay.
I would like to have it lit if you'd like to have it lit. If you want that lit, we'll light it.
Let's light it.
Let us have the reading of the scriptures, okay? Will you read the scriptures? Let me work on it.
Good afternoon. Now reading from Paul's letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now, we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I'm fully known.
So the brother has read the scriptures there, talking about love, God's love in chapter 13 of 1 Corinthians. He says, though I speak with tongues of men, of angels, and have not love, it profits me nothing. But the love that God's talking about is a love that we don't really know. This is in the Greek, it's agape love. It's a love that's unconditional. It's a love wherewith God hath loved us, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe upon him should not perish,
but have everlasting life. Not that we did anything or have done anything worthy of our salvation, but it's God's love towards us. It's an unconditional love. Regardless of what we've done, he loves us. Love can hide a multitude of sins, the Bible says. And when we love with the love of God, we're going to love unconditionally, not if you do this for me or if you do that. It's a love that you're going to love, a pure love. It's the kind of love that God wants us to have. And when we ask him in our life, it says the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. And so that kind of love that God has loved us with, that we're able to love others and forgive them, even as God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven us. In marriage, you'll find that in life, you're going to need that kind of love. You're going to have to love, even when it isn't really, you might not want to love with your flesh.
You don't really care, but you're going to love anyhow, because you really love. Not just love for what you're going to get from someone, but to love them because you care about every part of them, and you're concerned about their feelings, their emotions, and their appetites, everything and every desire that a person has. Inside of every one of us, when God made us, he made us after his likeness. He formed man out of the dust of the earth. He said, let us make man after our likeness, after our image. And he formed him out of the dust of the earth, and it was just a body that lay there, like somebody that's dead. They don't talk, they don't think, they have no feelings or no emotions. And then God breathed into man's nostrils. He breathed the spirit into man, and man became a living soul. So God made us triune with a body, soul, and a spirit. Our spirit is where our decision center is, where we make all of our decisions and our choices. As here today, as Jeff, you, and Mary, you have made a decision and a choice to bring your two lives together, that you might become one flesh. That these two lives, you're going to make them one. Okay, you made that decision, okay, by your understanding with your spirit. But your feelings, your emotions, your desires, and your appetite is where your love comes from. It comes from your soul. And that's where your feelings, emotions, and appetites are. And so this emotion and the feeling that you have one toward another have brought you together. It's not something that you're looking at. It's the part of man that you can't see. It's that incorruptible part, the part that never dies, that the soul and spirit will continue forever in every one of us. And so as you care about that part of man, the feelings, the emotions, then you're going to love one another even as he has loved us. You're going to submit yourselves one to another as he wants us to do. He says, wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church. When God made man, he made Adam. So it was not good for a man to be alone. And so God took the man and caused a deep sleep to come up on him. And he took out his rib and closed up the flesh. And then God made the woman. And he brought the woman to Adam. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. For this cause a man shall leave his mother and father, and they too shall be one flesh. So
we see that God took from Adam's rib. He didn't take it from his head bone, that a man could have dominion over the woman. He didn't take it from his foot bone, so that he could trample upon her. But he took her from his rib, which is near to his heart, under his arm, where he could protect her and care for her, even as Christ cared for the church. When a man loves his wife, he loves his own self. And so, as God instituted marriage and said, you're now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh, and as you two have lit the candle today, as you have lit that single candle, the other two representing you, Jeff, and you, Mary, that you brought your two lives together and you blowed out the candle, you're done being the single person, and now you're going to be responsible as one individual, as two people becoming one. Our prayers and our blessings are with you, and always continue to be with you, praying that not only in this life that we can have this love and care for one another, but God has promised us everlasting life, that when the soul and spirit leaves the body, to wait the resurrection, there will be a resurrection day, and we can be together for all eternity. Not only you, Jeff, your family also. And so thank God for him bringing this light to us, that we could have this knowledge, which gives us a hope that goes beyond this life. But in this life, our prayers is that you'll be prosperous and be in good health, and that the Lord will bless you and your home and your family. Let's pray. Father God, in Jesus' name, we just want to hold Jeff and Mary up here before you. Lord, now these two have become one. And therefore, Lord God, in your eyes, you said marriage is honorable and the bed is undefiled. And therefore, Lord God, as they have come together, Lord, and they have done that which was honorable in your sight, Father, we pray your blessings upon them, your mercy and grace for their past. We just pray, God, that they'll look to you. And Lord, that they'll let you become the author and the finisher of their faith, that they might continue in this life, Lord, not only as one with one another, but they might both, Lord, become one with you. That God, that they might walk in the light of this world. For you said, Lord Jesus, that you are the light of the world, and he that followeth after me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. And Father, we pray for that light to shine for these two people here, Lord God, who have just come together, Jeff and Mary, and the God, that you will bless them in all their ways, and will give you the praise and the glory and the honor, as we ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
For as much as Jeff and Mary have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have given and pledged their love each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, and by joined hands, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
God bless you.
Thank you.
You did good.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to present unto you Mr. and Mrs. Jeff Manown.
Thank you.
You gonna come?
Come here, baby.
Okay.
We had a little bit of difficulties, and then
it's all right. Josh.
She didn't even care.
Hi, love. How are you doing?
Say cheese.
Say cheese.
Look at the
camera. Cheese.
There we go. We got one picture. That's all.
That's all we need.
Mary.
Good.
In the background. Don't worry. My kid was in our wedding, too.
You need some by yourself, though.
I'm hot.
I'm too.
Okay, where's my mom?
She left.
With Nicole.
She needed to
use my car.
Oh, no, don't go far.
I have to wait for Jeff.
He's right there. He's smoking.
He's not. He's
been just hanging out.
Jeff, come here.
Hurry up.
There's water or something.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please direct your attention to the bar area. It's time to welcome everyone here into the wedding. We're going to start off with grandparents of the bride, Mr. and Mrs. Margie and Ken Goodrum. Also, grandparents of the bride, Miss Mary Summer, escorted by grandfather, Mr. Richard Yoder. Let's get ready and welcome father of the groom, Mr. Buddy Manown, escorted by aunt of the bride, Sandra Painter. Mother of the the groom, Miss Brenda Wine, escorted by Mr. Jeff Wine. And everyone, our beautiful flower girl, Ava Ann Klein. Here she is, escorted by Rick Bear, son of the bride and groom, Jeffrey Richard Manown. We're going to move to our bridal party, folks. Start off with our first couple. Bridesmaid, cousin of the bride, Alyssa Imbrogno, escorted by brother of the bride, Billy Marco. Bridesmaid, friend of the bride, Cassie Stewart, escorted by groomsman, uncle of the bride, William Summer. Bridesmaid, cousin of the groom, Lindsay McNeil, escorted by groomsman, cousin of the groom, Thomas McNeil. Bridesmaid, cousin of the groom, Joelle McReith, escorted by groomsman, cousin of the groom, Ryan McReith. Next we have matron of honor and cousin of the bride, Haley Harris, escorted by groomsman and friend of the groom, Stewie. Yes, and finally our maid of honor, best friend of the bride, Rachel Klein, escorted by best man, best friend of the groom, Josh Seeky. Ladies and gentlemen, get off your feet, put your hands together, and let's welcome for the first time here to the party, the brand new Mr. and Mrs. Jeff and Mary Manown! Let's give it up for her one more time! Ladies and gentlemen, Jeff and Mary are gonna dance for the first time as husband and wife. It's the first dance, ladies and gentlemen.
Come here, Jeffrey. Come here, Mary. Stop.
spinning you round and round in circles. It ain't my style.
Time, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for these two. Jeff and Mary, their first dance as husband and wife. This time we're going to ask the bridal party to come on out and join Jeff and Mary. Bridal party dance. Head on out to the dance floor.
Where's Billy?
Oh, the camera's right there.
Look who loves me all the love I've known. But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom. Yeah.
gentlemen, one more time for Jeff and Mary and their bridal party. All right. All right, this time we're going to have everyone take our seats. And we're going to get to some toasts and dinner coming up here. Sit tight.
Thank you very much. It is only fitting that we would come here tonight to honor Mary and Jeff in the spirit of Jesus Christ, and seeing them married in the name of the Holy Spirit was something very special, and it honored us to do that and to be here and to share that with them. And tonight we will share fellowship and we wish them well and they make their lives together. One of the things that brings to mind on this is that Jesus liked weddings. He performed his first miracle at Cana where he turned the water into wine. It turned into, it wasn't Mogan David 2020, but it was some good stuff from what they tell me in the Bible. And for Jeff and Mary, it's appropriate that we would be here and start memories of our own. But we also want to honor not just the memory of this evening, but we want to honor other people who with Jesus, who are with Jesus now and cannot be with us. And one of those who was very special to Mary was Rick, her father. We also are honoring in the memory of Mary's grandparents and Jeff's grandparents who cannot be with us. And on this very day, a number of years ago, Jesus found it necessary to take a very special person, Paul Corbett Jr., known as Murph. He was the best brother-in-law a person could ever have, and he was Mary's uncle, and we missed Murph very, very much. So that's enough serious stuff. It's now time to have the hoedown. So Jeff and Mary, let's do it.
Thank you very much, Tony. And lastly, we'd like to call up Pastor Frank Rocco to grab the mic to do our blessing tonight.
Well, let us unite our hearts together in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Lord God, we just want to thank you and praise you for Jesus. And thank you, Lord, for this beautiful day and evening that we have together. Always welcoming you in our presence and just asking your blessings right now upon Mary and Jeff. Just pray, God, Lord, that you make this a beautiful day for them. And pray, God, that they'll continue, Lord, with the joy that they have in their hearts right now, one for another. Just asking, Lord, that your blessings be upon them, your guidance, direction, protection be with them. We call upon you now, Lord, for your presence here as we ask your blessings upon the food, upon the hands that prepared it, upon the means of which you provided it. We thank you, Lord, that you made the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and you made the beasts of the field, and you made us. And Lord, you do provide for us all. You feed the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and the beasts of the field. But Lord God, when you made us after your image and your likeness. You made us triune. You made us eternal. You made us the highest of your creation. And you said that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of your mouth. And Lord God, you brought us the gospel, your glorious gospel, Lord, which brings us everlasting life, which we pray for Mary and for Jeff right now, Lord, as they continue their life, that they'll continue seeking you, walk with you in this life, and walk with you in the next as well, as we hold them up and ask your blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the head table will be served, and they ask you here to please remain seated, and you will be dismissed to the buffet. So please just remain seated and you'll be dismissed to the buffet. Enjoy dinner.
Let's hear it for these two.
Don't move.
ladies and gentlemen. I know we're ready to get to the fun part of the evening here. We're going to be opening up the dance floor shortly. We have a few special dances to do, so if you'll direct your attention here to the center dance floor. Mary's out here with, oh, you know who. Jeffy. Hey, let's call up Mary's pap. Now, Richard, one of Mary's paps. Let's start with Richard. Come on up, Richard. We have Richard here. Here in the room tonight, if you are married, including our newlyweds, we're going to ask you to come out to the dance floor. We're going to play a little game and see who's been married the longest. All the married couples, come on out here. We're going to do a couple slow ones and honor all of you here tonight for, sticking to one another for so long.
Come on, married
All the married couples, come on out. A couple oldies by request. Start eliminating couples based on how long we've been married. So we'll start with, if you've been married less than, I don't know, 5 hours, please leave the dance floor. Where are they? They're not even out here. Are they? They're over there. Alright, if you've been married 5 years or less, 5 hours or less, you can leave the dance floor. Alright, 10 years of marriage or less, 10 years of marriage or less, see you later. Or less, 15 years or less. All right, let's see what 20 years of marriage does. 20 years or less. Oh, they didn't do anything. I'm gonna have to get another song. I'd have to play Freebird. How about, here's a nice milestone. 25 years of marriage or less. 25 or less. Ah, that does it for some of you. All right. Still have a nice floor out here. Let's give it up for the folks who are still out here. All right, we're going to move to 30 years of marriage or less. 30 years of marriage or less. Of marriage, 40 years or less. We have 8 couples left. Wow. 8 couples, 40 years of marriage or more. That's awesome. All right, let's move up to 45 years. 45 years or less. That's a big one. That's a big one. My love flows sure to the sea. Five couples left, everyone. a big one. The 50th. 50 years of marriage or less. Please leave the dance floor. We're down to three, everyone. Let's hear it for these three. I've never had to do three songs. This is great. We're going to do one. Let's do 51 years of marriage or less. 51?
That ain't me!
Let's do it for 51.
That's me and you, buddy.
All right, we'll do 52. 52 years. Let's hear it for these two. 52 years. Congratulations. How about 53 years? Is that good? Let's hear it for both of these couples. And finally, our final couple out here. How many years? 59. Holy cow, 59 years of marriage. Congratulations. Wow, we wish the same for Jeff and Mary. Picture here. For everyone in here, all you newlyweds in the last 5 years or so. I said last 5 years. You're included. 59 years. All right. Well, we're going to move right along with some more fun stuff here tonight. All the single ladies, 16 years of age or older, all you single ladies, come on out here, please, for the bouquet toss. All you single ladies in the house, single women, come on up. Don't disappoint now. Come on, folks. All you single ladies. Come on out. All right, Mary, I'll count down for you. We'll start at three. There we go. Three. Yeah. for this whole night. He had his smoke break, so he's good. Let's give Jeff some encouragement, folks. Single guys in the house, come on out here. Single guys. Single guys 16 or older, come on out, please. Is there anyone here, Jeff?
Hey, where's Billy?
Not too many.
Billy, come on. You're zero.
Any single guys, come on out. Even if you have a girlfriend, she won't mind. All the single dudes.
Just like high school! It's just fun!
Hey, Jeffy! Hey, Jeffy!
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give this man some encouragement. The further up her leg you go, you know, more years good luck for Jeff and Mary. Keep going, above the knee. Let's hear it for these two. Even souvenirs. Slipper around, folks. have some fun here tonight with Jeff and Mary. That was horrible. Are we ready to have some fun here tonight with Jeff and Mary? All right. My name is Johnny D. I'll be playing all your music. If you have any requests throughout the night, please let me know. So let's get to dancing. Let's get out here and do the Cupid Shuffle. come on up and dance with the bride. Here we go. If you didn't dance with the bride, last call, if you didn't dance with the bride, come on up and get in line. We've got some members of the Steel Curtain here with us.
Here we go, Pittsburgh.
the sweet ones tell me. Sports kick. Jeff and Mary would like everyone to join in. It's the seventh inning stretch. Yes, we'd like to sing Take Down to the Ball Game. Everyone will join in. Requests for some more polkas.
Why'd you go away and leave me, my Mary Lou? You went away and left me alone and so blue. Please come on back.
Only time.
Let's start. Cha-cha now, y'all. Now it's time to get funky. To the right now. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha real smooth. Let's go to work. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops this time. Two hops this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees. Get funky with it. Oh, yeah. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Reverse, reverse. Reverse, reverse. Cha-cha now, y'all. Cha-cha again. Cha-cha now, y'all. Cha-cha again. Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops, two hops. Two hops, two hops. Right foot, let's dump. Left foot, let's dump. Charlie Brown. Hop it out now. Slide to the right. Slide to the left. Take it back now, y'all. Cha-cha now, y'all. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, do that stuff, do it.
From Frankie, Natasha, and Dawn, congratulations and best of luck in your future.
Hey, Mary, this is Larry and Patty. We came 500 miles for this. We were not disappointed. Have a wonderful life and a wonderful marriage. Bye-bye.
Hey, Mary, congratulations. I'm here with baby Jack. Hope you have a long, happy marriage.
Mary and Jeff, I wish you the best of luck. I hope you have a long and happy marriage. Love you guys.
Hello, Mary and Jeff. Thank you so much for inviting me here. Congratulations! I'm having so much fun. I love you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you.
You guys are awesome. Thank you. Have a great one.
Hi, it's Larry and Cindy, cousins of the bride. And we just wanted to say good luck, congratulations, and many happy years.
This is for the bride and the groom. Please have a happy, happy life. Thank you.
Hi, Mary and Jeff. We wish you all the best of luck, many years of happiness, and may you have a bunch more kids.
Congratulations, guys.
Congratulations. Thanks for having us.
Yep, many good years of marriage.
Very good time.
Mary and Jeff. Maybe you have a happy life together, and we love you. Your Aunt Shirley.
Sorry to bother you, Mary!
Congratulations, Mary, for your wedding.
Congratulations.
Have a great life. Good luck, guys.
Have a great life. I hope you live to be 1,000.
I don't know when we've ever been to such a fun wedding. Best of luck and many, many years to both of you.
I just want to say welcome to the family, Mary. We had a great time tonight, and I saw that rainbow this morning, and that was for you.
Congratulations, Mary. We're so happy to have you in our family. You're the new Mary Manown. Thanks, babe. Love you.
Congratulations. Have a good time.
I wish Mary and Jeff the best of everything in life, and I hope they're happy and they last forever.
Congratulations, Mary and Jeff. Mary, your dad will be very proud of you.
Congratulations, Mary and Jeff. It's a wonderful wedding. I wish you the very best and happiness and life forever. Thank you.
Mary and Jeff have a wonderful life together, and I hope you have as much happiness as we've had. God bless you both. Much happiness.
Hi, Jeff and Mary. Congratulations. The best to you. Hope you have a long and happy marriage. Love you guys.
Congratulations on your special day.
Great wedding, Mary. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Jeff and Mary.
Hi, Mary. Congratulations. They told me I was going someplace else, but they brought me here instead. So, but you and Jeff have a happy life and wish you the best of luck. Thanks.
Best wishes. Woo! Woo! Merry wedding. We love you.
Hey, we love you.
Hi, Mary and Jeff. Just remember, Jeff, happy wife, happy life.
Hey, same here. Good luck.
Good luck, Mary and Jeff. Stay married a long, long time. 50 years. Then that'll be enough.
We wish you nothing but the best and years of happiness.
Jeff, Mary, good luck with everything, and thank you for tonight.
Wonderful wedding.
This is to Jeff and Mary. I knew Jeffrey since he was born, when he was as big as my little finger. He's been a good kid his whole life. I'm so proud of both of them. Mary's a great girl. He got a nice pickup. They got a nice little boy, Jeffy, and I wish them all the luck.
Good luck to you guys.
All right. Hey, Jeff and Mary, congratulations.
Best wishes to all three of you. Live a happy life.
Glad you had us here. Beautiful time, man. Thank you.
Hey, Jeff, this is one day I hope you'll remember for the rest of your life, you and Mary. I'm so glad everything went perfect, and I'm proud of both of you. Congratulations. Thanks a lot. This is Pam here, my coworker.
Congratulations.
Hey, Jeffy!
Hi, Mary and Jeff. So glad you got married today. We had a great time. Thanks for inviting us.
Congratulations. Have a fantastic honeymoon.
Hi, Mary and Jeff. I'm so happy to be here. I hope you guys have a great day.
Bye. Love you guys. Thanks for including us in your day.
Hi, Mary and Jeff. You have a beautiful wedding here tonight, and I wish you all the happiness in the world. So congratulations again. I love you both. Carol.
Congratulations, Mary and Jeff. We love you.
Have a wonderful evening. Blessed day. Oh, I can't see, but
okay, she's cut off.
Have a wonderful wedding. No, I'm not cut off. So nice to be here at your beautiful wedding reception. Enjoy each other and love each other for the rest of your life.
You're stuck now. You can't back out.
Congratulations.
Go.
Junior and Mary, y'all been there for me, and I wouldn't miss this for the world. Y'all more welcome to come to our farm anytime you want.
It was a long drive at 3 o'clock in the morning from Tennessee, but congratulations.
Yep, congratulations.
Congratulations, Mary and Jeff. You should have had liquor at your wedding, but this will do. Thanks.
Okay, Mary, you don't have to call me every day now. Now that you're married. Good luck. You and Jeff need each other bad. Okay, thank you.
Hey, what's up, man? We had a great time.
We had a great time tonight.
Congratulations, Jeff and Mary. I'm happy for them both.
It was a fantastic day, but I was nervous as hell. And I want to thank everyone that was with me. And especially the people that came out from out of state. I love them. And I love Mary. She's the best thing that ever happened to me.
Don't cry. It was a lot of hard work, stress, and I was really nervous, and I was afraid something was going to go wrong, but it ended up being perfect. And I want to thank everyone who came here to make our day special and everything like that.
Yes, the people who came far away, I love them. And plus, my boss that came far away, I want to introduce him. Joey Miller. Joey. He's been there for the most hard for me. I'm appreciating him coming there for me. Joey's been there from the rough, everything else. He comes from Tennessee.
It'd be the best. I don't care, y'all are the best. My door is always open, and I say this 1,000 times. All you gotta do is give me 24-hour notice, and I'll be there.
He's one of the top two things that, you know, happened to me for my work field. He's the best ever. He's the best friend.
I ain't the best.
You're the best. And I want to thank him for coming here and everyone else to coming here. Best time ever.
Thank you.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for these two. Jeff and Mary, their first dance as husband and wife.